Kalkal will sell tomorrow.
Sir, Mr. Chairman, sir,
yes,
may I begin?
Please.
You called me.
Nothing else will go on record.
Sir.
Nothing else will go on record. Sri H.U.B. kindly speak.
I am initiating this discussion on the notice that you read out with a deep sense of anguish, anger and anxiety of what is going to happen to our country, sir. Because I believe that what happened in the Hyderabad Central University, what happened in JNU, these are not matters confined to only one or two educational institutions in our country. You've seen what happened with the Pune Institute. You've seen what's happened in IIT Chennai. You've seen what's happening in Jadavpur, apart from Hyderabad and JNU. You've seen what is happening in Allahabad. You've seen what is happening in Burdwan. You've seen various places, sir, these sort of instances that are happening. And I would like to submit here that it is not only institutes of higher education and universities, but also institutions like the ICHR, ICSSR, the Nehru Memorial Museum. In all these matters, you see an interference of an order that is not sanctioned by law. Every single institution, central university, has been established by an act of parliament. It runs on the basis of an act of parliament. And if this act of parliament is violated, it is our duty to intervene to ensure that such violations are put an end to. Therefore, at the outset, I am demanding, sir, that we should constitute a house committee to actually go into all these developments in Hyderabad University and in JNU. And because it's our responsibility to answer these questions that have been raised. Now, come to the substantive points. You see an effort in the field of higher education and education in general of what I would describe as an effort to replace Indian history, the syncretic evolution of Indian history, what all of us are products of and what we have gained, to replace that with Hindu mythology, to replace history with mythology, to replace the rich Indian philosophy with Hindu theology. This is the larger project at work, and this project actually dovetails to the project which this government is patronizing, the project of metamorphosing India's secular democratic republic into what they call the Hindu Rashtra. And this, therefore, sir, is an assault on the Constitution of India as I conceive it. And unfortunately, the government is leading this insurrection against the Indian Constitution, against the Republic of India. And why I say that, let me substantiate. The Hyderabad Central University, let's take up that issue first, briefly. Hyderabad Central University, all of us know what has happened in terms of how the Dalit students are being treated. Whatever happened in the past, there are a large number of Dalit students who committed suicides in that university, we all know. But that doesn't absolve what has happened now with the tragic suicide of Rohit Vimula. These students' action was taken upon, socially ostracized, their scholarships were stopped, and a Dalit student whose single mother brought up two of her sons in order to reach institutes of higher education through, you know, the sort of jobs that Dalits can do in our country, and through that she's brought up these children, and stopping the scholarships is actually means virtually murdering them. And then you do that, and then you create a situation where the student commits suicide. Yes, we were told that an honorable minister of this government wrote a letter about some clash between two student groups. The proctorial inquiry of the university took place. The matter was settled. After that, there was intervention. And we are being told that all of you write letters to the minister. Yes, we all write letters to the minister. There's nothing wrong. I've also written letters to the minister about various things happening in various central universities. I've written letters to the minister asking for admission in central schools that is outside of my constituency or my remit. Writing letters to the minister is no offense. All of us do it. Many a time we get an acknowledgement saying that your letter has been received, the matter is being looked into. Receiving letters of acknowledgement is also the job of the minister. So it's not ordinary letters that have been written and answers given. You have five senior officers of the ministry intervening, telling the university to take action. That's a partisan intervention. And that partisan intervention is not according to any constitutional foundations or basis in our country. And that is what we are saying, that the government has exceeded the brief of answering only letters, or that all of us are writing letters to the minister. We all will do, as long as we are public servants. And therefore, the matter here is, through this intervention, a situation has been created that led to this tragic death. We have been demanding, sir, when we had the two-day special session on Parliament to pay homage to Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, we have said mere peroration in speeches is not sufficient to pay homage. Come with concrete legislative agenda. Come with agenda why you will discuss after 60 years, why is this not being fulfilled, even the limited objective of reservations. How, due to the privatization of these economic policies, the public sector is being curtailed, and reservations in jobs that the public sector could provide are shrinking by the day. Need for considering reservations in the private sector. We said, bring in this question of implementation of the SCST laws, make it more punitive. But nothing of that was done. If you are really concerned about the role of the Dalits paying homage to Dr. Ambedkar, and what did he say, sir, in the final thing? I've quoted it a number of times, I don't want to repeat the entire quotation. That we have given ourselves a political structure where we have given every citizen of us a vote. Each vote has the same value. One person, one vote, one value. Dr. Ambedkar warned us, if this one vote, one value does not change rapidly into one person, one value, then this political structure will not remain. It will be thrown asunder. This is what Dr. Ambedkar warned. And what are we doing in that direction? We'll discuss that. When the motion of thanks for the president comes, when the budget comes, we'll discuss that, what we are doing there. But the point is, the creating an egalitarian society where, as the constitution promises, we give irrespective of caste, creed and sex, unquote. Irrespective of caste, creed and sex, equality. That is the equality that we have given to ourselves in this constitution. And that is being violated. This is a very serious matter that goes beyond just some trouble in some university. This is a serious matter of what is the state's role in intervention. And if the state promotes this role of intervention that is anti-Dalit, that is something we in the parliament will have to take note of, because that university was created by an act you and I passed here. And if we don't take a note of it and suggest the interventive action, then I'm sorry, we are abandoning our responsibility. And therefore, I raise this, that's why I said, with a sense of anxiety, a sense of anger and anguish. And now, come to JNU, sir. We have been products of the Jawaharlal Nehru University. The ministers in this cabinet who have been products of Jawaharlal Nehru University. At the outset, we had said, the day after that, I met the Honorable Home Minister. He was here a little while ago. I met the Honorable Home Minister, along with our colleagues, Mr. D. Raja and K.C. Tyagi. And we told him that if there is anybody who has raised anything anti-national, take action on the basis of credible evidence. You assure us that no innocent will be punished. We were assured. Immediately comes a reference to a tweet by that noted terrorist who was let loose by an earlier BJP government, Hafiz Saeed. Comes a tweet saying that Hafiz Saeed has supported these students. Now, can you imagine a situation in any country, sir, where the Union Home Minister, the repository of all inputs from intelligence agencies, he gives a tweet and retracts. He did that on Pathankot. He gives a tweet about Hafiz Saeed and retracts. The Delhi police puts out an alert. Delhi police puts out an alert saying that this is a false tweet account. And on that basis, you are proceeding. By all means, let me assure this house, and we have done it an umpteen number of times, any anti-national act or any act that encourages terrorism is something that cannot be not dealt with. Strictest action must be taken. But in the name of that, to penalize the university as a whole, that I think is most unfortunate, because after all, it is these youngsters, sir, today, what Sardar Patel had once called the steel frame of India. The steel frame of India, your administrative service, your foreign service, your police service, your media, your academia, your intelligence. I can name the officers today in this government who are products of JNU who are leading this. Madam External Affairs Minister is here. The Foreign Secretary of our country is from JNU. The Home Minister is not here. But the special cell you have appointed now to take care of the terrorist threats emanating from the ISIS and the danger to India is headed by a JNU student. Hopefully they know that she is the minister of the cabinet. that I don't want to remind them. But where all do you want me to go? There's no field where the students have excelled. And today you castigate the entire university as being anti-national. You say that these are the enemies of our country, the students here. By all means, you take it. And what is happening, sir? Nathuram Godse. Nathuram Godse, the murderer of Mahatma Gandhi, will be a national hero. And Sitaram Yechuri and deputy chairman will be anti-national. Is this the nationalism you have to seek? You are saying to instill nationalism in the students, there will be a huge national flag in every central university, 207 meters or feet. Very good. You put it all over the country. But remember, sir, remember, the tricolor in our hearts, the national flag in our hearts, is much larger than all the national flags that they can put together. And you don't have to teach us Deshbhakti. We don't want certificates of patriotism by these sort of double standards that they practice. And I tell you, I come from a student organization that I have headed there in JNU. We all come, and with pride we used to say, with pride, one of our colleagues was attacked by terrorists in Northeast. His body was cut, put in Assam. His body was cut. I'll name him if you want. But he's dead and gone, is a martyr. Niranjan Talukdar, his body was cut, put in a gunny bag and thrown into a well. It couldn't be found for more than a month. Later, from the dentist's account, they confirmed that that's the body. What was the slogan we gave in JNU, sir? Hamari, jism tukde tukde ho sakte hai, lekin is desh ko tukde nahi hone denge. Hum is terrorism ke khilaf hum khade hain. Aur aaj deshbhakti ki hamare liye is tarike ki pravachan hote. अगर यहां पर कोई समस्या है तो उसको हल करने की कोशिश करिए आप. सेडिशन एक्ट, महात्मा गांधी को जेल किया उसमें, बाल गंगाधर तिलक को जेल हुए उसमें. आजादी के समय हम सबको ये वादा दिया था कि उस सेडिशन एक्ट को हम निकाल देंगे हमारे कानून से. निकाले नहीं. भगत सिंह प्यार से फांसी चूमते हुए वो देश के अंदर वो शहीद हुए इसी सेडिशन एक्ट के अंदर. और आज इस सेडिशन एक्ट को इस्तेमाल करते हो आप अपने स्टूडेंट्स के ऊपर. और वो जब अपनी बात करने के लिए उठते हैं उनके ऊपर हमला. दिल्ली की पुलिस आपके अंडर है महोदय गृहमंत्री जी. दिल्ली की पुलिस कमिश्नर कहते हैं कि अंटिल दे प्रूव देयर इनोसेंस दे आर गिल्टी. पुलिस कमिश्नर कहता है इन्वर्टिंग द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ जूरिस्प्रूडेंस. लीडर ऑफ द हाउस माननीय वकील है, ये बताइए ये कहां से न्याय हुआ सर? और वहां पर उनकी पिटाई होती है, मीडिया में दिखाई देता है, एविडेंस जो देते हैं सरकार की तरफ या अथॉरिटीज की तरफ जो भी है वो प्रूव होता है कि वो सब डॉक्टर्ड है, वो सब फैब्रिकेटेड है. अगर आवाज उठाओ तो पीटो उनको कोर्ट में. अरे सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने एक टीम ऑफ लॉयर्स भेजा उधर आपके पटियाला कोर्ट में सुपरवाइज करने के लिए. एक उसके अंदर एक सदस्य थे जो हमारे साथ रहे थे राज्यसभा के अंदर और फॉर्मर मिनिस्टर, उनकी पिटाई होती है. क्या हो रहा सर देश में? और यही मैं सवाल पूछना चाहता हूं गृहमंत्री महोदय से, हो क्या रहा? न्यायालय में न्याय दिलवाइए, वो नहीं हो सकता तो पिटाई, और पिटाई करने वाले के बारे में कोई आज भी शब्द नहीं है। बीजेपी के दिल्ली के एमएलए सुना है, गर्व से कहते थे एक पूरी ऑपोजिशन इतनी छोटी हो गई कि वो एक सिटी बस में घूम सकते हैं। दिल्ली चुनाव के बाद हमने कहा दिल्ली में तो अब बीजेपी थ्री व्हीलर में घूमेगी। अब उनमें से एक जाके पिटाई करते हैं, गर्व से कहते हैं कि भाई देशभक्त हूं मैं, मुझे पिटाई करने की इजाजत है। कौन कौन से तय करेगा? और वही विदेश, इतने देश घूम के आया हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जी, उसी विदेश के न्यूयॉर्क टाइम्स की एडिटोरियल पढ़िए आप। यू वॉन्ट मी टू रीड इट आउट सर? रीड आउट द न्यूयॉर्क टाइम्स एडिटोरियल, इट्स ए लीडर इन द पेपर। इंडिया इज इन द थ्रोट्स ऑफ ए वायलेंट क्लैश, प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी एंड हिज पॉलिटिकल अलायंस ऑन द हिंदू राइट डिटरमिन्ड टू साइलेंस डिसेंट, न्यूयॉर्क टाइम्स। लॉयर्स एंड बीजेपी सपोर्टर्स चैंटिंग ग्लोरी टू मदर इंडिया and traitors leave India, assaulted journalists and students, the police refuse to intervene, New York Times, Le Monde, one of the most respected papers in Europe, they have written editorials about what is happening in India. What is all these foreign tours and all this getting support for India abroad if this is what is happening? And that is where, sir, I want to really here draw your attention to the serious fact why I said it's an insurrection against the Constitution. The Constitution gives me the rights. A secular democratic India, dharma nirpeksh jantantra ka gantantra Bharat hai, us Bharat mein mai paida hua hun. Mere hisab se yahan pe kai sare log hai us Bharat mein paida hue. Hamare liye Bhagavad Gita, hamare liye Bible, hamare liye Quran, ye Constitution hai sir, ye. और इस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के चलते हुए जो अधिकार हमें देते हो, आप हर नागरिक को देते हो, इस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के शपथ लेकर हम यहाँ पे आए, आप वहाँ पे बैठे हो, ये सरकार है इस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के शपथ लेकर। अब इसके अंदर कोई विरोध करता आपके नीतियों का, कोई अगर नारा उठाता है कुछ आपके खिलाफ, वो देशद्रोही है। आज़ादी के नारे लगे सुना मैंने, बिल्कुल लगे आज़ादी के नारे, हम भी लगाते रहे, अरेस्ट करिए हमें, हमें चाहते हैं आज़ादी भूख से, हम चाहते हैं आज़ादी बेकारी से, हम चाहते हैं आज़ादी मनुवाद से, हम चाहेंगे आज़ादी संघवाद से भी, और ये आज़ादी हम चाहते हैं, और ये आज़ादी हम चाहते हैं, इस आज़ादी के लिए लड़ेंगे। इसकी अधिकार मुझे ये कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन देता है, और इसीलिए मैं कह रहा हूँ। अब नेशनलिज्म के सवाल आ गए, अब कहते गुरुदेव रविंद्रनाथ की किताब, अगर आपको चाहे तो हम आपको भेंट कर सकते हैं, या पढ़ लीजिए इसको, जिन्होंने जनगणमन लिखा था, जिसको हमने स्वीकार किया, खड़े होते हैं हम सब अटेंशन पे, वो हमारी इज्जत है अपने देश के लिए, और वो ये लोगों के लिए। अब नेशनलिज्म आप कहते हो कि वही नेशनलिज्म है जो हम कहेंगे, वही नेशनलिज्म है, और ये नेशनलिज्म से ऊपर उठ के रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर, सुभाष चंद्र बोस, आपके महात्मा गांधी, सब लोगों ने लिखा। व्हाट इज इंडिया सर? वी आर द क्रूसिबल, दीज लैंड्स आर द क्रूसिबल ऑफ सिविलाइजेशन एडवांस ऑफ द ह्यूमैनिटी, नॉट ओनली इन आवर कंट्री। वी गेव द वर्ल्ड सो मेनी थिंग्स बिकॉज ऑफ विच मॉडर्न सिविलाइजेशन एग्जिस्ट टुडे एज इट इज, एंड टू से ऑल दीज आर प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ हिंदू सिविलाइजेशन इज रॉन्ग। Most of these advances came when Buddhism was the reigning religion in our country. And it's only when it came back with your caste hierarchical order, Manuwad, as we call it, for jisse hame azadi chahiye, tab ye pura advance jo hai ruk gaya. And we want to catch those threads. Agar Dara Shikoh ki baat kahe, to kahenge ye Babar ki aulad hai. अरे जो मजमाउल बहरेन लिखा, संस्कृत पढ़ के आपके वेदा, आपके उपनिषद आज अगर दुनिया जानती है तो दारा शिकोह ने करवाया। अब वो बाबर की औलाद है, मजमाउल बहरेन ऑफ Islamic Sufism and Vedantic Indian traditions, the mingling of these two oceans. India was moving to a much higher spiritual society, sir. We were moving to a much higher spiritual society that has been thwarted. And therefore, I am beseeching this house to seriously think about it. It's not a one offense or two offenses. By all means, if anybody has taken anti-Indian position or anti-Indian activity, take action. But in the name of that, you're castigating an entire university? And is that what all of us here have come to, sir? I've quoted in this house a number of times earlier. Ashoka, the Trimurti that you are sitting under, the four lion pillar, inscribed on that pillar, from where we have taken the symbol of our nationhood. Inscribed on that pillar is Ashoka's edict that irrespective of whatever sect anybody may follow, irrespective of whatever faith anybody may have, the job of the state is to protect that faith. Bhagavad Gita, what does Lord Krishna say? Madam External Affairs Minister wants that to be the holy book of our country, but what does it say? That I shall preserve the faith of every individual in every form that he may choose for his faith. Are we doing that? I'm seriously, are we doing that? Are we realizing today the potential of what India can be? Instead of that, you're confined it into the narrow domestic walls, like Rabindranath Tagore said. Narrow domestic walls, whereby what I define as nationalism is nationalism. That is why, sir, I don't want to go into that. We have been saying that the left is like witches. But remember, this is the 400th year of the birth of a genius. I don't know if it was one man who wrote all that, William Shakespeare. He was one individual who wrote all the corpus that he wrote. Remember his play Macbeth, where there's a song of the witches. If you're comparing us with the witches, then listen to this song. And what does this song say? Double, double toil and trouble. Double, double toil and trouble. Fire burn and cauldron bubble. And then what do they say that is being produced? For a charm of powerful trouble, like a hell broth boil and bubble. Hell broth boil and bubble. This is the song of the witches. And this is what is happening. For a charm of powerful trouble. Charm of powerful trouble. Like a hell, broth boil and bubble. Yes, we are witches, we forewarn. We are witches, sir, we forewarn what is going to happen. And like in Macbeth, the witches forewarn. Macbeth can be the king, but the line of kings will come from Branko. You may be the king today. The line of kings in India will come from another Branko, not from you. So if you call us witches, then also understand the prophecy of the witches, which comes out to be true. And being forewarned is being forearmed. That is why we are saying, we are calling upon the people to be forearmed against this attack that is happening on the name of nationalism, that is basically a certain brand of religiosity. And that is why, sir, you and I and all of us, we've all grown up in this world. We have grown up in this country where Islamic influences, Christian influences are there. I'm born in a Hindu traditional family. Had my Ved part done and my thread ceremony done at the age of 11, having studied all the Vedas, then you say, with a name like Sitaram, with all the Vedas, why have you landed up as a communist? I've landed up as a communist because I've studied all of them. So don't teach us all this. If you want to debate, argue, come. Debate, argue, and that is how our philosophy grew, through debate and argument, and that's exactly what they want to suppress today, sir. And said, do not suppress. And that is why, remember, our Prime Minister went to a convocation recently of the Banaras Hindu University. So did Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru go to a convocation of the Allahabad University. And in that Allahabad University convocation, Jawaharlal Nehru, what does he say about the universities? I quote, "A university stands for humanism, for tolerance, for reason, for the adventure of ideas, and for the search of truth. It stands for the onward march of human race towards even higher objectives. If the universities discharge their duties adequately, then all is well with the people and the nation." Unquote. And an adventure of ideas, of tolerism, of humanism. You castigate that entire universities. You say that is anti-national, needs to be closed down. 40 years ago, that used to be the editorials in the Panchajanya, Organizer. They said it's a den of anti-national activity. It must be closed down. Today, the leaders of the ruling party say that it should be closed down.
They want to take a tank there.
And now they're taking a tank, not only a flag. They want to take a tank there. Sir, whether it is BJP or it is the Congress party, I don't normally take names of parties. Yes, during emergency, we did not allow the university court meeting inside the university. Mrs. Indira Gandhi was our chancellor. We said we are protesting against emergency, we will not hold. Allow that meeting. It was taken to Vigyan Bhavan. We fought against assaults on democracy. Likewise, today, with renewed vigor, people are fighting assaults on our secular order. They're fighting assaults on our secular order, and therefore suppressing dissent is not the Indian constitution or Indian democracy. And therefore, sir, I really beseech you, let us decide today after this debate to have a house committee to go into what is happening in all the central universities and institutions that we have established through an act of the parliament. Each one of them has a separate act. We are responsible finally to the country if something is going wrong there. Bring it to us. And don't say we all write letters. We all write letters. I'm not ashamed of saying it. But our letter doesn't get the attention of your colleague minister who gets it. And five officers go on reminding the university take action against him. Rohit Vemula's death is the result of that. And that is why a Dalit, the slogan of Azadi against Manuvad will remain, sir. If you want to arrest me for that, arrest me. I will give that slogan. I will give the slogan of Azadi against hunger. I am ashamed of my country that 5 children die every day in the world due to hunger. 3 of them come from India. And that is why I am saying, please do not castigate these students or the university. Please stop this tirade against them, because in order to advance your brand of nationalism, in order to advance and transform the secular democratic republic of India into a version of a theocratic fascistic Hindu Rashtra. And that is my sincere appeal. And therefore, through you, I want to beseech upon this government, please, the richness of our plural society, the richness of all of us who belong to different faiths, different castes, different languages, different cultures, we are all welded together in this great country called India. I have my point of view, you'll have your points of view, they'll have their points of view. And only with the debate and discussion do we rise to higher levels. Do not destroy that potential of India. And therefore, my appeal to this august house, my appeal through you to the government and to all my colleagues is, let us have a house committee to inquire into what is happening. What is anti-national, let us punish it with the greatest vigor. Let us redeem our pledge to remove the sedition clause, which can be misused as it's being misused. Let us ensure that the job of the police is to maintain law and order, not to assist the disruption of law and order. And let us, for heaven's sake, be responsible to our constitution and to our people. And that is my firm belief. So, maafi chahta hu main, azadi ke nare hum bhi lagayenge. भूख से आज़ादी चाहिए, मनवाद से आज़ादी चाहिए, गरीबी से आज़ादी चाहिए, इस देश को बेहतर बनाने के लिए जो भी इसका नुकसान कर रहा है उससे आज़ादी चाहिए। और इसीलिए मैं कह रहा हूँ, बाबा साहब की वार्निंग फिर से दोहरा रहा हूँ, याद रखिए, हर इंसान को एक वोट, हर वोट का मूल्य एक, लेकिन हर इंसान का मूल्य एक जब तक नहीं होगा ये ढांचा खड़ा रहने में दिक्कत होगी। तो उस आधार पे मेरी विनम्रता से ये अपील है कि बंद करिए इस तरीके के षड्यंत्र और अटैक अपने बच्चों पे। यही बच्चे हैं जो हमारे फ्यूचर हिंदुस्तान बनाएंगे, भारत को बनाएंगे। अब उनको कह दो आप देशद्रोही, तो आप और हम क्या कर लेंगे? तीन चौथा हमारा देश का नौजवान है, अगर उसको जो है स्वास्थ्य दो, उसको शिक्षा दो, उसको रोजगार दो, तो एक बेहतर भारत वो खुद बनाएगा। आपकी हमारी कोई जरूरत नहीं, हमारा काम सिर्फ यही है कि वो दिलवाए। सो यही मेरी विनम्रता से कहना है कि आप इस तरीके के अटैक्स को बंद करिए और हमारी देश की विकास के लिए आगे बढ़ने के लिए सामूहिक तरीके से चले। थैंक यू सर,
थैंक यू वेरी मच। नाउ श्री गुलाम नबी आजाद।
It will be over by 12 o'clock.
No, don't think. At 12 we will break and then question hour will be taken.
Then you can put somebody else speak.
Okay.